Welcome back. So up next, let's go ahead and talk about view composers. Now you are familiar with what a view is, but you may not be familiar with what a view composer is. But before I can show you what view composers fix, I need to show you the actual problem. So to do that, we're gonna do it the traditional way. And then of course, as we always do, we're gonna get deeper and deeper until we cover everything there is to know about view composers. So let's go ahead and jump into PHP Storm. And I have a totally fresh Laravel 6 project right here. The only thing I did behind the scenes was just simply set up a database. I am using SQLite, and we've covered that on the channel already. So let's get right to it. So I have this idea of channels, meaning channels that a post can belong to. Now the idea behind it is that we're gonna have a list of channels, and we're going to need to display them to the user whenever they create a new post. That way they can associate their post to a channel. And of course, we're gonna have a list of channels spread throughout our UI where we allow users to maybe filter by channels. So here is the setup. So let's go ahead and create a new model, a migration, and a controller for channels. So to do that, we can say PHP artisan make model channel, and we can pass in the flag of F for factory. This is a model factory, M for migration, and C for controller. So this is gonna create all four files at the same exact time. All right, so let's open up the create channels table. And the only thing I'm going to have here is just simply a string for name. We're gonna keep it very simple, and that's all I need. So now let me jump over to the channel factory. And in here, of course, we only have the one field for name. So this will use Faker, we'll say Faker, just give me a word. That's all I need. All right, so with that, let's go ahead and migrate the database. And then let's go ahead and actually add some channels to our database. So I'll say PHP artisan tinker. And of course, I can use a factory. So we'll say factory app channel class. And let's go ahead and create 20 of them and let's persist them to the database. So there we go. We have 20 fake channels in our database. All right, so now let's think about this for a second. If I visited the following route, we'll say route is going to be a get route, and the route we'll just call it channels. Then I expect to hit the channel controller at index method. Okay, so let's jump to the channel controller. And of course, let's add our index method. So in here, I need to fetch all of my channels. So to do that, of course, we'll use the model. And we'll say, go ahead and give me all of them. And then I can return a new view, which doesn't exist yet. But if you've watched Coder's Tape long enough, you know exactly how I name all of my views. So I'll reach into the channel directory, and then the file name will be index.blade.php. So let's jump into resources, views, and let's create a new file inside a channel directory. And we'll call it index.blade.php. So in here, we're gonna have a simple HTML, and we'll just name this channels. And of course, in my body, I can have an unordered list for each channels as channel. Go ahead and spit out a list item with my channel name. Okay, and then end for each. Great, all right, let's check this out in the browser and let's see if we made any mistakes. Okay, and we get undefined variable channels. Okay, let's jump back into the controller. Yes, I generated my channel, but I forgot to actually send it in to the view. So we'll go ahead and do that right now. We'll say channels, we'll pass that through. And now, sure enough, we have a list of our 20 channels that we generated. Okay, so far so good. But now somewhere else in our application, we're gonna have this concept of posts. So let's go ahead and create a new controller. We'll say PHP artisan, make a controller for posts. So we'll say post controller. And now in my post controller, I'm going to have, say, the create. This is the form that someone will fill out to create a new post in our application. So let's go ahead and run a create. And I'm going to need my channels again. So I will actually do this one more time. And we'll say channel all. Okay. And then we're going to return a view. And again, the view will be post.create. And let's go ahead and compact the channels. That way we have them accessible to our form, because in our form, we're gonna have a dropdown. So let's go ahead and create that file now. Post create.blade.php. And inside of this, we're gonna have create new posts. And of course, we're going to have some sort of form in here, which won't go anywhere. But at some point, we're going to have a select route. And for name, let's call it channel ID. For ID, we'll also say channel underscore ID. And then inside of here, we're going to do something similar to here. So why don't I copy this, bring it over. But of course, it's not a list item. This is going to need to be an option. So as an option, my value will be the channel ID. And as the name, of course, just channel name. Are you with me? So this is all it is. It's just a form. Let's go ahead and create a route so we can actually see it. So this is maybe going to be posts slash creates. And this will hit a post controller at the create method. Again, we're just creating the world. So you see how we run into a problem here very shortly. So now we can visit slash post slash create. And I'll actually open it in a new tab. That way we can still have them side by side. So this is my list of channels. And then here we have my create form. And my create form, of course, has some sort of list here where we get to choose what channel it is. Again, very, very basic stuff. I just want you to understand the concept of view composers. Okay, so imagine the following. Somebody comes back and says, hey, I like the channels, but I'd like for them to be in alphabetical order. Okay. Now imagine that we had used the same exact logic in maybe 5 different places in our application. So now we're having to search for every single instance, and we're going to have to do something like order by, let's order by the name, and then go ahead and get each one. So now in my post controller, yep, now they're in alphabetical order, but of course here they're still not in alphabetical order. So we'd have to keep searching, find my channel controller, and then make the exact same change here. So we'll say order by the name and then get me all of the results. So I hope at this point you can kind of start to see the pain point. The pain point of this is just that we have these channels that we need for every view inside our channel and probably every view inside my post. But every single time, I'm going to have to create a whole controller maybe to just pass in this one variable. So in comes view composers. Before I touch up on view composers, I do want to show you a way to actually share data across every single view. You're not going to use this very often, but you may run into it in a project, so you definitely want to know about it. So let's jump into my service provider, and I'll use the app service provider just for now, but of course you can create your very own service provider just for this. So in my app service provider, in my boot method, I can do the following. So I can use view, I can actually use the facade, right? So it would be the illuminate support facades view. Make sure that gets imported up there at the top. And then we can call this method called share. So share will accept 2 parameters. The first one is going to be the key, meaning what the variable name is going to be. In this case, channels. So I'll go ahead and copy channels into app service provider, and then we'll pass that in as a string. And then as a second argument is what you want channels to represent. So in my case, I'll go ahead and copy all of this, bring that in here. Now PHP Storm is going to detect that channel class needs to be imported. So I'll go ahead and import that automatically. But again, make sure that you add that up here at the top. So now every single view is going to have a channels variable. And you may be thinking, this is either great or this is the worst idea ever. And I'm with you on both cases. Like I said, very, very few times you're actually going to use this because if you remember, we're actually creating a query. So we're going to be hitting the database every single time a view gets created. So you definitely don't want to overuse this. Word of caution, do not share unless it's absolutely necessary that you do that. And I would definitely not do it with something like a query. I would really do this more in case you need to share some important information that every single view needs to know about. But again, this is not very common, so just keep that in mind. But with that change, I'm going to actually delete that line completely, and I no longer need to pass my compact line. And I'll do the same thing in my channel controller. And I will also delete the compact section. But if I refresh, sure enough, that's still in there. And if I refresh this, we still have our channels. Now, just to prove that that is working, I will disable that line. I hit refresh. And all of a sudden, undefined variable channels for both of them. So that's how we know that this, of course, is what's being taken over. So like I said, just as a quick recap, this will share a channels variable with every single view. Okay, so that's going to be option one, every single view. So I'll comment that line out, but I'll just leave it there so you can continue to see what we're working on. So up next, let's actually talk about view composers. So a view composer, the very basics of it is that you can attach to specific views some data, a lot like how we attached this channels data to every single view. So to do that, we could say view, same exact view, we're using the facade for view, and we can say composer, and now we can specify either one or many views. So you can either pass in a string or you can pass in an array with many strings attached to your views. And I'll show you how to do that in just a second. But as a second argument, you're gonna have a callback. So this callback will accept our view, and then we need to go ahead and attach whatever data we want in that case. All right, so how do we select what views get this special data? Well, to do that, we're gonna pass in a string very similar to the string that we pass in a controller. So we'll say post.create. We'll go ahead and pass that one in. And then we know that we also need our channel.index. So we'll go ahead and add that as a second one. So now every single time the create.blade file gets called inside the post, and every single time the index inside the channels directory gets called, we can attach some data to it. So to attach a data, we'll take our view and then we'll say with, and then inside of here is exactly the same thing that we had up here. So I'll actually copy it. So we'll say with channels variable, go ahead and attach all of those. Again, the biggest difference between option one and this one is that now we're being very granular about who gets this channels data. Only the create and only the index. Only those two views are actually receiving the data. So let's go ahead and just confirm that everything is still working. Refresh a couple of times. Yep, that's working. I'll go ahead and disable this just to prove. And there we go. And that fails again. We'll turn them back on. And I think you understand how that works at this point. Again, one added benefit we didn't really talk about is the fact that if tomorrow we needed to maybe change this to descending order as opposed to ascending order, easy enough, that's change and that's change. One single change changes everything in our application. Anybody who uses this channels variable in terms of views will now have the new order automatically. We don't have to chase down every single controller that uses the channels. So this is option two. So this one will be granular views with wildcards. And I actually haven't shown you how to do a wildcard. So to do a wildcard, say that you have this post directory and you want every single view inside of that. Instead of create, we simply pass in an asterisk. This means that every single view that pertains to the post will get this channels. So that's another nice way. Again, this all works exactly the same. But that's another nice way that you can pass in a wildcard. So again, anything that's inside this post directory right here, any of the views inside of here will get this new channels variable. So that's option two. But of course, as with everything in Laravel, we have many options. So let's move on to option three. So you can achieve the same thing, but we can encapsulate it in a class, in its own class. Granted, for this example, where it's a single line, it probably makes a lot of sense to just use this callback using option two. However, if you have a really data intensive method that needs a lot of calculations, this is going to get a little gruesome if it's inside your app service provider or any other service provider. So for that, that's where having its own dedicated class really comes into play. Now, Laravel in the documentation, it actually doesn't tell you where they should be created, but it does hint at the fact that they should be inside HTTP. And inside of there, you can create a new directory for view. And inside this view directory, you can create another directory for composers. And that's where they should live. Now, this is not a written in stone, but that's where the Laravel documentation puts them. So let's go ahead and follow that. Now let's create a new PHP class inside of composers, and we'll call it channels composer. Any composer class only requires to have one method in it. It can have as many as you want, but the only one that it absolutely has to have is one called compose. Compose will accept view. Now the view that it accepts is not the facade. It is actually illuminate view view. So a little bit different than when we were using it in our app service provider. Again, as a quick side note, the one that we are importing up here is Illuminate Support Facades View. That's different from this one. This one is Illuminate View View. This is the actual view class. So with our view, we can do the exact same thing as we had in option two. We can take our view and simply bring it in here. So again, now we've encapsulated this in its own class. You can have as many other methods in here as you need to calculate whatever the data is that you're trying to pass to your view, but everything gets encapsulated in this view composer. So everything is in its single file. That's the added benefit with this. So to call option three, let's call it option three. This is dedicated class. We're going to use the view facade again, and now we're going to use the same composer, and we can actually pass in the exact same array. But as a second argument, we're not going to pass a callback. We're just simply going to reference our view composer class, the channels composer. So we'll just say channels composer class, and this will need to be imported up at the top. So there it is. It's being imported up here automatically for us. All right, so there it is. So with this, let's go ahead and hit refresh. And it looks like we made a mistake here somewhere. And what it is that this public function should be called compose, not composer. So with that, there we go. So now we're just getting that the channel is not found because I forgot to import this class. So now let's go ahead and import channel. That's up here now. And with any luck, we're back to working. I'll hit refresh on this one, and sure enough. And again, just to prove that that works, I'll go ahead and comment out this channel composer. That one blows up, and this one blows up. All right, great. So that is working. So now before we wrap up this lesson, that is essentially everything there is to know about view composers. However, there is one refactor that I want to show you that I commonly use whenever I need to do something like this. Because what's going to happen is that if later down the road, here comes the third instance that you need to use these channels in, now you're having to actually come back into your app service provider and add that into your composer list. And that's not super ideal. So I actually like to extract that into a partial. So let me show you what that actually looks like. Stick with me for a couple of more minutes and we're gonna cover this refactor. I think you'll enjoy it. So let me go ahead and refactor. And what I want to do is I want to extract it from my create, and I also want to extract it from my index. So I'll close everything and let me open up my index blade file as well. So in question, I want to extract this and I want to extract this. Two different versions of the way we're showing it. Obviously one way is just a list and the other way is a dropdown. So let's go into my views, and inside my views directory, inside resources, I'm going to add a new directory for partials. Now inside of partials, let's add a new directory, and this one is going to be channels. So inside of channels, I'm going to have two versions of this. The first version is going to be a dropdown. You can also call it menu if you want to, but we'll call it dropdown.blade.php. And the second version I'm going to have is, of course, a list. So we'll just say list.blade.php. Okay, so here is my dropdown version, and I'll actually select everything. I'll cut that one out, and let's bring it into dropdown. So now inside of here, all I need to do is just go ahead and include this new partial that we just created. So we'll say partials.channels.dropdown. Okay, so that's one refactor. Then, of course, we have our list. So let me go ahead and grab my list from here. I'll cut it out, bring it into here. And again, we'll do the same thing. We'll include partials.channels.list. Okay, so that is refactor out, and this one is refactor out. But now, of course, I need to change my view composer. So let me go back one last time to my app service provider. And what I'm going to do here is I will keep option three. It doesn't matter. It would really work with either two or three. And all I need to do now is pass in a single place. It's going to be inside partials, inside channels, and then any view inside of there as a partial or channel. So if I had a third version of this, then it would already work because we're simply grabbing the entire partials inside the channels. And at this point, we don't need this to even be an array. It can actually be just a string. All right, so if I refresh here, we still have the same thing. as we did before, but again, with the added benefit that now all we need to do is just include our channels, either the drop-down version or include the list version. So now one last little customization thing that you may want to do is the following. This channel ID here or any other field inside of this partial can be customized. So what we can do is maybe set a reasonable default, but then allow the user to customize it. So we can do that by saying the following. Okay, go ahead and output field, but if you don't have it, let's go ahead and just output channel underscore ID. And I'll do the same thing for the ID of my select. So now if we come back here, let me open the source. And now we see that our select has a name of channel ID and an ID of channel underscore ID. But if I need to customize this, say in my create method for some odd reason, I need to call this something else, I can pass in an array as a second parameter and I can say, okay, my field is actually going to be called maybe my channels, just something else. So now when I refresh, notice that this has been customized. So this increases the flexibility for partials. It's very important to remember, you can always create a place for you to customize something about your partial, but still provide a reasonable default. So that way, if we don't specify a field, of course, we get a nice reasonable default of channel ID. But if for some odd reason, I needed to customize that or anything else, because remember, we're not just limited to this. We can add as many of these customizations as we need. Our view in this case only has 5 lines, but it may have hundreds of lines. You may need to customize some stuff inside of it. So that's it for this episode. That is View Composers with a ton of extra tips for you and stuff that I've picked up along the way, and they have come in very handy. So I hope they do the same for you. With that, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, share all the videos. Let's spread the word about Coder's Tape. My name is Victor, and thanks for watching.